Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic on the structural and the functional unit of life, that is cell. So let's see the another cell organelle, that is Golgi apparatus, or which is also called as Golgi complex. Now Golgi apparatus consists of a system of membrane bound vesicles arranged approximately parallel to each other in the stacks called as cisternas. Now Golgi apparatus is concerned with the secretion like glycoproteins, or you can say glycolipid, and storage of proteins, carbohydrates and lipids. They synthesize complex carbohydrates from simple sugars, and they are mainly responsible for the primary lysosome. This was discovered by Camillo Golgi. He was a neurologist in 1898 in the nervous tissue. And the Golgi complex consists of mainly the aggregation of, as you can see, the several hundred membrane bound bodies forming an arched assembly or the simple flattened group. Now Dalton and Felix in 1954 were the first to discover this ultrastructure of Golgi body. Next, cell organelles, lysosomes. These lysosomes are also called as suicidal bags. Okay, and the reason because of this is that the cell, if metabolized, if the metabolism of the cell is disturbed, the lysosome gets burst and digests its own self. That means it can digest, or you can say destroy itself. Due to this, they are called as suicidal bags. These are a kind of waste disposal system of the cell, and they help to keep all the cell clean with the help of powerful digestive enzyme. And the this powerful digestive enzyme is the lysozyme, which is present inside the lysosomes. And due to this, they are called as suicidal bags. As you can see in the picture, these are the lysosomes which contain the enzyme lysozyme. And after this, the procedure of the digestion of any food particle, this through exocytosis, that means through the after elimination, these lysozyme act on these food materials and they are eliminated. Next comes the mitochondria. Mitochondria is called as a powerhouse of the cell, and as the energy is required for various processes of life, so this mitochondria is a main organelle which synthesizes, or you can say which makes the energy in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate molecules. ATP is also called as the energy currency of the cell, and mitochondria also have their own DNA. As we have seen, that the DNA is mainly present in the nucleus, but mitochondria has self DNA. As you can see in the mitochondria, this cisterna is present, this is the matrix here present, this is inner layer, and there is also outer layer present in the mitochondria. The cavity of the mitochondria is filled with a dense fluid which is called as mitochondrial DNA, and these projections are called as cisternae. Next comes the plastids. Plastids are only present in the plant cell. There are three types of plastids mainly: the chromoplast, leucoplast and the chloroplast. Now chromoplast are the colored plastids, leucoplast are the colorless plastids, and the chloroplast, the name itself says, they are also colored plastids which can be red, green, blue and yellow in color. These chloroplasts are mainly present inside the leaves, due to which the leaves have green color. Next comes the vacuoles. These are also the cell organelles which are also present mainly in the plant cell. They are nothing but the storage sacs for the solid or liquid contents of the cell. So the main responsible of function of the vacuole is the storage. Vacuoles are smaller in animals and larger in plants cells. So mainly the large number, we can say, the vacuoles are present in large size in the plant cells. Vacuoles also provide turgidity as well as rigidity to the cell. So students, in this session we have completed the cell organelles. Thank you.